want to win everything with Arsenal.
That's excellent from Saliba.
That's class defending.
Saliba, very cool with score.
A quite brilliant finish from a centre half.
I want to become a legend here and with the national team as well.
You go to any town in and around Paris, you will find players. It's a state of mind, it's a way of living.
William Saliba is just one of many stories that we've heard, certainly in France, of this kid from the Paris banlieue, where football is his life, playing all the time after school, at school, at the weekend in his grassroots team, that then make it all the way to the top. And this is Saliba for you. It could be Mbappé, it could be many others. He started at Bondi, which is the same club that Kylian Mbappé came from. Kylian's dad was actually William's first coach. And from there on, there was just no doubt when he was 12, 13, that he would become a footballer. So naturally, he was picked up by a really good academy in France, in Saint-Étienne.
You know, you expect it to take a while for a central defender to really come of age. But the maturity that was there, as well as the physical characteristics, was really apparent.
It was just a question of when is a bigger club going to come and poach him? And that club was Arsenal for 30 million euros, which now looks like an absolute bargain.
After signing for Arsenal, the club he supported as a boy, Saliba returned to Saint-Étienne on loan, with further spells at Nice and Marseille, providing invaluable experience for the young Frenchman.
Football is not easy. Sometimes you have to wait. Sometimes you have to grow up and to get some experience.
At Nice, things went really well. He learned, he developed even more than Marseille, where he played in the Champions League.
Saliba's form with Marseille earned the boy from Bondi a reunion with his childhood friend, Kylian Mbappé, making his debut for France in a friendly win over the Ivory Coast.
That last season in Marseille, he was so good. It felt like he was better than a lot of the central defenders that were at Arsenal already.
He's a player that has developed incredibly well, that has had the minutes and exposure that we wanted in a really competitive league, and that is ready now to contribute to our club.
Oh, that's superb defending by William Saliba. Saliba stands firm.
I think he was just what Arteta was looking for in terms of being dominating, but in terms of being very careful in possession as well. So he's someone who can keep the game flowing.
The strength that he has is his speed. He's such a rapid player.
When you're in a 1v1 with him, you're like, okay, you're not going anywhere, big man.
He's a talker, and I think that's what's really key. And even going off my experiences and past, that the team wasn't really a communicating team, and I think that says a lot what Mikel's brought to this environment. He's allowed the players to actually have a voice.
He gives that calmness to the team, especially in the back line, and his presence there is unbelievable.
Barely a bead of sweat from William Saliba.
I think the complementarity with Gabriel is very important. Of course, central defending is all about partnerships. I think if you have one who's the battler, which is Gabriel, and the one who has the more widescreen view, who's a bit more circumspect and mops up, and the qualities in possession to do that, that's Saliba. And that's why they click together so well.
It was easy because he speaks French. It's easy because he's so good.
É jogador de muita qualidade, como todos vocês sabem. É cedo para falar, mas nós trabalhamos muito dia a dia, então acredito que por isso que estamos tendo bons resultados.
When you have good players around you, you can't be bad.
Saliba played every minute of Arsenal's 2023-24 Premier League campaign, as the Gunners narrowly missed out on the title. And it's a tale of near misses for the defender, who was also part of the France squad that finished as runners-up at the 2022 World Cup. Saliba and his compatriots will be desperate to go one better this summer.
He's a key part of that squad, and whether he starts or not, we'll have to see. I think France are incredibly gifted in terms of centre-backs, more than any other positions. The strength and depth that we have at centre-back is just absolutely incredible.
Think if you compare his form to other French central defenders at the moment, there's no one better than him.
I think this year he was for me the best centre back in the league.
He's delivering every week, and I think for him the Euro will be a great platform for him to show himself in an international level.
I think Saliba can go all the way because he's already most of the way there. I think people realise exactly how good he is, that he is one of the best central defenders in the world.
I think he's got all the talent, potential, all the tools, everything, really, to be one of the greatest.
I felt that from outside world, it comes like, okay, a Hungarian guy coming to the Premier League, he will not play, he will not do well. In my mind, I was like, no, I'm gonna show it.
Amikor óvodás volt, és ugye úgymond elindult, akkor azért én már foglalkoztam vele, mint apa is, meg mint edző is. És ugye hát a foci volt az én fő profilom, és ebbe ő bekapcsolódott, mert állandóan jött velem mérkőzésekre, az edzésekre, és akkor ő is csinálta, szerette csinálni.
From 3 until 7, every day the same. Trained with my own team, trained with the youngest, trained with the elders.
Ő Ronaldo fan volt ilyen szempontból, volt a példaképe, de mondtam, hogy ne Ronaldo legyél, meg nem Messi legyél, hogyha gondolkodsz bármiben is, hanem Dominik legyél.
He was with me always harder than with the others. Even the other parents was like, why you so hard with him? Why you so hard with him?
Ő nem a Puskás, ő nem az Albert Flóri, hanem ő a Szoboszlai Dominik.
He wanted me always to be the best, better than them, do more than them, and that's why he was like this.
The early stages in Salzburg were very difficult. Obviously, I was very young, without the family, without the friends, in a new environment.
Voltak ilyen holdpontok, hogy felhívott, de ugye én egy szívtelen apa vagyok, és én letettem a telefont, és mondtam, hogy old meg. Volt, hogy hívott, hogy elég, senki nincs benne az akadémián, én megyek, elmegyek haza, vagy mondom, sehova nem mész az akadémián, vagy te most ott élsz, találd fel magad.
It was difficult, with a lot of tears, but at the end he coped with those difficulties very, very well. And I think that is one of the reasons why he ended up being a super professional.
Remember the first meeting I had with him. He's an elegant player, but he's kind of an elegant person as well. I called him in front of the team and I said, it's your time now, it's clear. And he exploded. He was unstoppable.
Then Leipzig came. I was like, okay, Bundesliga, not a huge step, but a big step.
He was injured for a long time in Leipzig. He had a difficult time. He kept on working. He stayed confident. He never lost the belief in himself.
Early on, I could see when he would go with the national team that he was the hope of the nation. But Szobo wanted that. He wants that responsibility on his shoulder. Rossi made him captain. He's ready for that responsibility.
We were impressed by his personality from the beginning, since he was 18. All the teammates supported our decision to give to Dominik the armband.
Diagonal! In that young age, it's of course a big responsibility, but I felt that he was ready. He's been in the top leagues now over many years, and he has that kind of experience to be the captain.
I was not surprised that Liverpool signed him. I know how Kloppo is working, what he's asking for, what kind of players he likes. I think these two guys came together in the right moment, on the right place.
We had talks, obviously, and there was a really nice, funny young man. This natural confidence, this kind of charisma, yeah, you have it or you don't have it, and he has it definitely.
The desire of Dominik was always to play in one of the top 5 to 8 clubs in the world. when Liverpool came, when Jurgen Klopp came, it was something really special.
He just said he wants me to join the club, and I say, okay, if it's on me, then I'm coming.
Comes the corner, which caused some problems, and Szoboszlai hits it! What a start for Liverpool! And what a hit, by the way!
He was already pretty good without the ball, but I think he's gone to another level now, winning tackles, turning the ball over, and moving as effectively in the other direction as he does with the ball towards the opposition goal.
The running power of this guy is just quite brilliant. He's been magnificent today.
Let me say, if the whole midfield is a little bit too adventurous and it's gone, you can be sure that he would be the one who protects all that, because he sees these kind of things.
He's a game changer. He really is. He's been impressive since the moment he walked through the door at Liverpool.
It's nice to see that the Hungarian player coming through the ranks, make it to the one of the top teams in the world, and that he can perform at that level.
Oh, lovely. Nodded in with a touch of nonchalance by Dominik Szoboszlai.
I just want to continue like this. I want to win trophies, all of them.
In my mind, there's no doubt that Hungary can be one of the real big surprises and dark horses of the competition. They don't have too many stars. Szoboszlai is the big outlier in that respect.
You can just feel that, you know, football is getting more and more important again in people's life, and that kind of connection again with the fans is there.
Hungarians are in love of football. They are waiting since a lot of time to be able to identify someone that could be more similar to the bigger icons of the past, that was Ferenc Puskás.
It's an iconic player, the best player ever played in Hungary, no doubt. But I want to do my own thing. I want to be for the kids, not the new Puskás, the new Szoboszlai.
La verdad que ella es como mi casa. Cuando venimos a jugar de local, creo que ya se hace. Es como venir al patio de tu casa. Y la ciudad es eso, tipo, hay gente muy amistosa. Eso lo vi desde un principio. Yo empecé a los 7 años en mi club de barrio, que era el club, se llama 3 de noviembre. Y después cuando ya a mí que me tocó jugar en Cerro, en el club allá de Paraguay, a los 14 años.
It's a very interesting journey, the one of Almirón.
Cuando tuve la oferta de Lanús con mi representante, la verdad que no dudé, porque me iba a beneficiar en todos los aspectos, ya sea futbolísticamente, en lo personal, económicamente. Iba a ser un paso muy grande para mí en mi carrera.
He's absolutely decisive for a kind of lesser Buenos Aires club, Lanús, and he helps them win the title.
Yo pude lograr 2 campeonatos con el club y salí muy bien ahí con recuerdos muy lindos.
The normal path, or the traditional path, then would have been Argentina, Europe, or possibly from Lanús on to Boca Juniors or River Plate, and then on to Europe. Instead of which, he goes to Atlanta United, Major League Soccer.
El primer año que pasamos en Atlanta fue un año muy lindo, y luego el segundo año ya estuvimos más compactos, el equipo ya se conocía más, nosotros logramos la liga allá en Estados Unidos, y mi representante me dice que el Rafa Benítez, estaba en ese entonces el Rafa Benítez era el entrenador acá en Newcastle, me dice que estaba interesado en mí. En la etapa que yo llegué pasábamos momentos malos, igual la gente venía, te pide autógrafos, te apoya, es algo que nunca lo viví hasta que llegué acá.
There's always this thing of a little kid about him. Sometimes, I think, maybe in the early days at Newcastle, a little kid lost.
Almirón, he's in, he touches heavy.
a familiar story.
When he arrived in the Premier League in 2019, sometimes he was trying to do these things, but he was a bit all over the place.
Al comienzo no me fue tan bien. Tardé un año en hacer un gol. Me costó mucho. Pero luego me fui afianzando. También creo que es gracias a la gente que siempre estuvo ahí apoyándome.
It's been a long wait, but finally Paraguayan gets his reward.
When you join a club like Newcastle, like in Almirón's case, then of course that comes with a big pressure. You know, the whole of that city lives for that football club. And yeah, he definitely carried responsibility playing for them.
Fast, direct, likes to dribble.
Almirón exploded into life under Eddie Howe.
Oh, my goodness gracious me! That was sensational!
Almirón will shoot!
St. James's Park in full voice!
The Paraguayan has endeared himself to the Newcastle fans.
He's a lot quicker than people give him credit for. He's now shown that he can score and assist.
Sí, la verdad que todo el mundo sabe que mis características son la velocidad, trato de técnicamente también me defiendo.
Every time I watch Almirón, I have a soft spot for him. He has this endearing personality, but at the same time on the pitch he just fights and he pours his heart out.
To have Almirón in the Premier League, this is wonderful for Paraguayan football.
He's the most valuable player in the history of Paraguayan football. In tournaments or in qualifiers, people don't look at Paraguay expecting many things.
He's 30. Almirón now has to be the senior statesman in the Paraguayan attacking force. All right, he's never going to be the out-and-out league goal scorer, but Almirón is the one who is expected to tip the balance. If he's not scoring, he's expected to provide. So this Copa America will be a vital tournament for Paraguay to try and unlock the potential of Miguel Almirón.
Ahora tenemos la Copa América, que para mí va a ser muy importante, no solamente para mí, sino para mis compañeros también. Y yo creo que nos va a ir bien.
You become the most important player for the national team because you're playing the most important league. And so you become this crucial part of the Paraguayan national team. So, yeah, he's a superstar.
Siempre digo, voy a estar agradecido con la gente por el cariño que me mostró de un comienzo. Me siento muy bendecido también de...
I remember just going out, playing on a car park close to my house, playing football at like the age of 6.
When you play in the street, your ball control has to be so good because you usually play in tight spaces.
I was so determined just to get the opportunity, and when it came, I just thought everything I trained for since I was a kid, I have to take it into the game.
The local kid, who also happens to be a fan of the team, that goes all the way through from a young age into the first team and wins a treble, I mean, that is literally the stuff that people dream of.
I think if you have a gem like that in your academy, a city or anywhere else really, you polish it, of course, but in a way that you don't take away that street culture, because this is what makes Phil Foden.
He's a young boy, a normal guy, quiet, and he just love football, love playing like a street boy, you know?
They just say, okay, we're going to teach you about the game and all the tactical side of it, everything, but keep that side of you, keep all that technical ability, that street-wise culture that you have, because that's what makes you special. In that 2017 World Cup, he was incredible from start to finish. They had one of the best generations they've ever had at youth football, really. So they were heavy favourites, and for them to go and win it was special.
Sometimes I watch the final over and over again, and just how we was 2-0 down at the time and how we came back was, you know, unbelievable. I've known him since I'm very young and he's obviously, I knew he was a great player back then, and I knew that if he kept on working hard, he would have reached the level that he's reached.
A world champion at youth level, a teenager whose reputation has long since preceded him. Tonight, Phil Foden makes his first Premier League start.
Foden was a passion project for Guardiola, someone that he wanted to almost create into the perfect attacking midfielder.
If you look at all the players that at one time or another, you know, came through Manchester City's youth ranks, and you ask yourself how many of them made the cut to becoming starters in the Pep Guardiola era, it's really only him.
I was a ball boy for a couple of years. Remember, like, seeing Aguero score and things like that, and then next minute, you know, you're playing with him, it's crazy.
It's like exhibit A of the guy who kind of ultimately left the manager no choice.
Phil have a sixth gear, but he cannot play all the time with sixth gear. Had to play with the second and the third. I think with the time he will learn that.
I think you have to give a lot of credit to Guardiola, because there was questions, why is he not going out on loan and why is he staying at Man City? He needs to play games, and Pep felt it was more beneficial to him to stay there and be around the top players in that environment.
He's not going anywhere else to pick up bad habits. Guardiola thinks almost it's only me who can help him become the best version of himself.
Hat-trick for the homegrown blue.
We're going to hothouse him in his perfect environment and make him the perfect footballer.
Yeah, he's looked after me. You know, he's played me in cup games to start off with, and yeah, he's built me up and he's been, you know, massive for me to see his tactics in training.
If you're looking for an arm around the shoulder and lots of love, he's perhaps not the number one coach, but when it comes to helping players fulfill their potential, I think very few can match what he's doing.
I believe that I've definitely become more mature on the pitch, and I think the manager sees that and he's been trusting me in more important games.
The history makers, the record breakers, the team that have simply been head and shoulders above the rest.
You've been in the club since you were 8 years old. This is your club. You've always supported it. Your family are City supporters. You've grown there. You've learned everything. And now you pay the club back by bringing the treble into Manchester. It must be incredible.
I'm happy for him because it's a dream come true when you're able to play at your club, at your home team. He's developing a lot and he can be one of the best players here at Man City for many, many, many years.
He can do anything. The trophies that he's won already and the major roles that he's played in those trophies is incredible. I'm a bit jealous that he's still only 23 and he's done all that and he's still got all these years to win more.
As amazing as this treble was for him, he must have thought, hang on, I'm 23 years old, this is just the beginning.
Stunning! A hat-trick for Phil Foden. What a moment for him!
I think this is a season where Phil Foden has gone from huge talent, will be an amazing player, to he is an amazing player.
He's already a legend. The games have, the goals have scored, the titles. He's the player of the season.
It's been a joint project, two men, to make him the best player in the Premier League.
The player of the year! Sounds like he's been worthy of such accolades!
We always want to be the best player in the world, that's for everyone, but, you know, I want to try and win as many trophies as possible and be the most decorated player.
He's still very young, but I think there's potential there to become the most technically gifted England player of all time.
I think he's the one player who has to start. It's so exciting, you know, the young players we've got, and Phil's certainly one who could spearhead us to victory.
I think this year, above all others, is looking like it's going to be Phil Foden's year for club and country.